Hey, check it. Hey, check it. Put the place up.
Guys, welcome back to another vlog, welcome back to another video. I'm Fly Rodo, singer, songwriter, producer, and on today's vlog, I want to talk about these guys, Tesla, and why I'm not getting the Model 3. Let's go. Alright, so on January 4th, I got an email from Tesla saying I can order the new Model 3. Previous to that, I had put a down payment, not a down payment, a reservation of $1,500 just to be on the list. Since I was a Model S owner previously, I got ahead in the line to get the Model 3. So January 4th comes around and I get the invitation to order the Model 3. You can look at the previous video where I spoke about ordering that Model 3. It was basically one model, the Model 3, which is rear wheel drive, starting at $49,000. It's 0-16, 5.1 seconds, 310 mile range, and they included the premium package. And obviously the autopilot is definitely something you must get if you own a Tesla, because that's just one of the coolest features. The final price on that was $54,000, which is about a loan payment of $775. So seeing that, I actually was more interested in the all-wheel drive where it has two motors, because definitely that was gonna be the speedier one. So they told us that mid 2018 they'd be releasing that option. So come June 27th, I get another email saying, hey, we have more new Model 3 options available, which include all-wheel drive, faster, and a new top speed. You have two options. You can do dual motor all-wheel drive, and they had the dual motor performance option. The difference in price from dual motor and dual motor performance options is about $11,000. That $11,000 gets you about 1 second better from 0-60 and a top speed of 155. When you go to design the top model, you have all the options and colors and wheels. There's also a new option in the interior where you have the white, which is $1,500 more, which looks really cool. And then obviously you want to get the autopilot. I will not get the full self-driving capability, because who knows if in the lifetime that you have that car, that's ever enabled. So once you see that final price of that, it's $75,500. And here's where my problem is. It is the comparability between a $75,000 electric car to a $75,000 gas car. I think the Model 3 lacks a lot in places in this price range. Yes, it is the fastest car in that mid-range luxury of $75,000, but it is not the best out of all. So let me go into a few little details. I made some notes on my car that I currently have, Model S, and there's a couple things that are lacking that I think are not super important, but it's definitely a luxury thing that you should be having in a $75,000 car. So for example, the trunk. The trunk on the Model 3 is mechanical, meaning it is not automatic. So you literally have to, when you press the key, it just opens, and you lift it, and to close it, you have to shut it down. On the Model S, it's all automatic, as you can see. So it opens and closes with the button, or if you press just the button on the trunk, it opens automatically and then closes automatically if you press the button again. Also, from inside the car on the screen, you can open it and close it. I think that's kind of a big deal. If you have a $75,000 car that doesn't have that, like, that's kind of insane, you know? Any other car, or Mercedes, a BMW, an Audi, all these have an electric trunk. Also, on this car, you also have mechanical door handles. So on the Model 3, you press in and you pull out to open the door. On my Model S 90D, you have these retracting door handles that just come out, you know, present themselves. I think this is really nice, luxurious detail on the car, you know? And once again, $75,000 does not have that. I've sat down inside the Model 3 and the car inside looks very minimalistic. It's okay, I understand the whole concept. And actually, when I got my Model S, I thought it was too simple inside and everything. but the Model 3 takes it another level, and it's even simpler. It has one screen that controls everything, and that's all you see. In front of you, you have nothing. I kind of don't like this. I really like the front dash screen in the Model S because I get to see a couple things right in front of me, and I don't have to stare to the side or change menus, like songs I'm playing, navigation, speed, the energy use, which I love looking at the energy use, making sure I'm driving a eco-friendly way. You also see your battery, the miles you've driven. You have all these clusters that are all there at once, as well as your big screen. And yeah, I think maybe you can get used to one screen, but having this other screen for all these other information that you can just see instead of having to go into menus, I think goes a long way. In comparison, really, it's those little details for me that go a long way when having a luxury car. If you're paying $75,000, you better have all the bells and whistles on top of having that electric battery and the speed and the performance. And yeah, that's cool, but there's other cars that also have that that don't cost $75,500. Maybe you can get a C300 with an AMG package for $60,000 and it has all the bells and whistles, and for the extra $10,000 of difference, you can just pay for the gas in the 3 years you're gonna own the car or lease the car or whatever it is. So for me, that's a big deal. So I'd rather look at other cars in that same price range. And yeah, I love that you can charge it and all that, but you don't have all the luxury for $75,000. All you're getting is performance and battery. So stick around for the next video and I'll tell you what car I could get instead of the Model 3. Peace. Oh, by the way, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't yet. Peace.
This is a Model 3 in the wild.
Looks pretty dope.
Nice car, man.
It's not mine.